working out on the bench in the lab. Yeah. Hey, it's Fran. In my art department, this is where I do all my pencil and ink work here in the office. And I wanted to make a video, sort of a follow-up to a video that I made just 3 weeks ago. I took some time off, took a couple weeks. I wouldn't call it a vacation. It was sort of a work staycation. I just basically wasn't publishing content, but I was just kind of working on stuff in the background for stuff that's going to go on this summer and stuff like that, but kind of a pause, and just 2 weeks. But now I have to make kind of like a follow-up for a video that I published just 3 weeks ago. It was titled "Subscriber Numbers Are Meaningless," and in that video I showed how over the last year, and particularly since the beginning of this year, that YouTube has once again changed the way that they're doing business without telling anyone. And the current issue is that they've dramatically cut the ad revenue to creators at the beginning of this year, especially. They started monetizing shorts, and it's very clear from the data that I showed in that video from just a few weeks ago that the amount of ad revenue that YouTube is actually giving to creators for making the sort of the legacy type YouTube videos that is in this sort of horizontal format and in lengths of more than 60 seconds, that being like traditional YouTube videos, that videos like this one are, yes, they're cutting the revenue a lot, showing that for the same number of views a video made today, as opposed to just a year ago, the amount of revenue that a creator like me would get from that video, it's anywhere from a third to a fifth of what it was even a year ago for the same views. Add to that the fact that when I made that video way back in 2018, WTF YouTube, the original video that got me all steamed that back then in 2018, YouTube had just again mysteriously just stopped sharing my videos, and I showed in painstaking detail in that video of 2018 exactly how the data showed that at some point earlier in that year of 2018, YouTube had simply just stopped circulating my videos, and I was only getting like 10% of the views that I had gotten before YouTube had taken my videos off the shelf. And I showed in that video in 2018 that the reason was that my channel at that time was not monetized, and this was just at the time when YouTube decided that they wanted channels to monetize their videos, and they said publicly very adamantly that no, there's no preference to monetize videos. We're not going to penalize you if you don't monetize your videos. If you don't have a monetized channel, you're going to be seen just the same as everyone else, and it's bad. It was a total lie. They absolutely totally pulled all my videos, and it was only because I monetized my channel after making that WTF video that, boom, you know, within weeks, my views were exactly where they were before the ban, and yes, that's exactly what it was. I hadn't monetized my channel, YouTube took my channel off the shelf, and now, this year, since the beginning of the year, the same thing's happened again. I showed in that video 3 weeks ago that I've been putting up a video every single day for the last year, and even though I had been very consistent in making content, that my viewership and my subscribership was just dropping off. I had stopped getting new subscribers, I wasn't getting new patrons, and it was clear that my viewership was not only getting small, it was just the same people who always watch my videos, and that's that the entire world of FranLab had become this little bubble, and without being seen outside of the usual bubble, there was no way to replace new patrons and get new support and actually grow the channel at all. And so the channel had just remained the same size for last year. And so when I made that video just 3 weeks ago, the mystery was, well, what has changed that is making my channel starve? Why am I being choked off even though I'm making all this content and I'm being very consistent and I'm following all of the rules, in air quotes? What has changed? Well, what's changed is that again, silently, YouTube has started promotions, just like Facebook did years ago. So now, when you go to the content creator page, there's a little tiny little tab there for promotion, and YouTube says, well, you know, if you're not being seen enough these days, maybe you should consider paying for promotion for your channel. And so they won't tell you up front what it'll cost you to get the same views you had a year ago. But now it's clear that pay to play is the new thing. And YouTube will say very adamantly again, oh no, it's not required that you have to pay us for people to see your videos. We're going to share your videos just the same as always. And that's just not true. So now they're taking just about all of the ad revenue. They're basically trickling the ad revenue to the creators to almost zero. So they're taking just about all of the ad revenue, and they no longer make it an option for you to not be monetized, because during the pandemic, YouTube had made the announcement that all videos on the platform will be monetized, and you can choose to take a little piece of it or not, but we're going to put ads on your videos no matter what, and you're not going to have a choice about that. So it isn't even a matter of demonetizing the videos. It just can't be done. Now the question remains, and boy, this is a question that I really do not want to have to answer, but the question is, how much is it going to cost for me to pay to get the same promotion that YouTube used to do just because I made content? And it doesn't take a genius to do the math really quickly about what kind of a landscape this is going to create very quickly, or let's say is creating right now on YouTube, where only the best financed channels with the biggest backers and the most money in their coffers are going to be seen first and foremost, and pretty much everyone else is just not going to be seen. It's bad enough that as a creator, I have to pay to make the content for YouTube. YouTube doesn't give me squat to make content. I have to raise the money on my own time to actually pay for the ability to create the content myself, put it up on YouTube, and then YouTube monetizes that content by putting ads on it, and they take all that money and they give less and less, almost none of it they give to me, almost none. And now on top of that, I'm going to have to pay, again, pay YouTube to show my videos, pay rent to YouTube. Where does it end? I mean, what's going to happen is, in a very short period of time, only channels that have really deep financing, ones that are affiliated with large corporations or huge sponsors, they're going to be the ones who are going to be seen in your feed, and nobody else, including me. And I'm really wondering when that date's going to come. It's obviously not going to be like in the distant future. It's going to be sooner than later. And I know that I will have to pay YouTube to promote my videos so that I can keep my patronage up. This is a huge problem that I got to solve. One of the things that I have decided over my staycation to do is that I'm going to be setting up a merch store, and I am going to start making t-shirts again, and I'm going to be adding other things, mugs, totes, stuff like that, with FranLab branded stuff, and also some other designs like the one I have here. So I make a lot of like sort of art, cartoon art and stuff, and I've been reluctant to like put it into the channel because people already complain that I have too much different kinds of content in the channel. I got music up there and some comedy bits and France and films and all this other stuff, and adding like cartoons to the mix, it might be too much. But I think that in the merch section, putting some of my designs on shirts and mugs and totes and stuff like that, it's going to be a way to generate some extra revenue. I don't know how much, probably not enough, but it's going to be one side hustle that's going to be happening in the upcoming weeks and through the rest of the year, setting up this merch store. So that's one thing that's going to happen. I'm going to launch that in June. There's also going to I'm going to have to do like regular like quarterly promotions for the Patreon, because again, if I don't do like special promotion, I can't get new patrons in to replace the patrons who have to leave. And you know, I always appreciate all of the support that I get from my patrons. They're the only reason that I'm able to do this. It's always the fact. And as a patron myself, because I patronize other people for periods of time and other projects and stuff like that, patrons come and go, and that's just natural cycle of things in the crowdsourcing world. That is just an accepted part of the whole thing. And it's no problem as long as you can get seen enough to bring in new people to give support for a period of time to replace the people who have to move on. And I just haven't been able to do that. I think in the entire month of May, I only got one new patron. All the other patrons that I'd gotten were patrons who had been patrons before who came back, or patrons who I already had who upped their support. But a lot of people left. And so without the ability to get out there in sort of the open ocean of YouTube, the way it used to be, you don't get new patrons. It's sort of like, it kills the cycle of things. It's like the biosphere. It's like the cycle of water. You know, if you interfere with any part of that cycle, bad things happen. And so YouTube, once again, they're messing up my whole cycle and making it impossible for me to get new people over to the FranLab area and see my stuff and get in, you know, to become a part of this whole thing. So, yes, it looks like I'm going to have to pay to play, and I do not know what it's going to cost, but obviously I'm going to be making a follow-up video about that after I give them some of my money with my teeth gritted firmly and wait for the data to come back and see exactly what I got for that money, and then up it and, you know, do like a couple different levels of promotion and see really what the results are in the data. But of course, this is going to take time, and we're just going to have to see. But yeah, payola is a real thing, and pay to play. It seems that this is the new reality on these YouTubes that here I am. I made 1,000 videos for YouTube at my own expense. And YouTube has made an absolute shit ton of money off of the ads that they've put on my videos over all these years. An absolute shit ton. And I've gotten very, very, very little from that. And now they're giving me practically no revenue at all. And I'm going to have to pay, on top of everything, pay rent to have this YouTube channel. Believe it or not. That's it for this one. I've said a lot, and I have already said too much. But thank you, thank you, thank you to everyone on Patreon. It's the only reason that I'm doing this. I said it before, I say it every video. It's the only reason I'm even able to do this. It's because of my patrons. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And if you like what I do, consider becoming a patron. Just go to the link in the description. I will thank you personally. I'm Fran. I'll be back, maybe not in the art room, but maybe in the studio, maybe in the lab, maybe at the big table, maybe over at the factory. Gonna be back over there soon, so you never know where I'm gonna be at the Fran Lab. All right. See you soon. Bye! Berserk in my lab, it's where I work. FranLab.
what I'm doing. Working at the bench again. I'm Fran.